Hi, I'm Ron Revord. I'm a PhD student in the Multifunctional Woody Polyculture program. My specific work focuses in on hazelnuts and breeding and genomic bottlenecks in U.S. breeding programs. So multifunctional woody polyculture encompasses three things. Multifunctionality typically refers to that you're getting a number of different ecological benefits, whether that's preventing or filtering runoff, carbon sequestration, habitat for other species. Woody typically refers to non-herbaceous crops, so trees or shrubs. And polyculture refers to having more than one species in that agricultural system. So in the new research site, which is about 30 acres, we have somewhere near 12,000 trees or shrubs. There are seven treatments that range from very simple polycultures, and then we get to some complex, crazy ones that could be a good substitute for CRP that have up to nine species in them.
All told, there are 10 species on the research farm, including chestnuts, European and European American hybrid hazelnuts, apples, plums, pecans, persimmons, and currants. What we're trying to learn with this long-term site is whether real-life multifunctional agriculture lives up to its theoretical benefits. We are tracking fuel use, water use, accounting for chemical applications. We are measuring how fast our plants grow and what sorts of animal species come make their home on our farm.
A lot of thought went into how we could make this research design both answer basic research questions regarding plant interactions, etc., but also how it could be a demonstration site for farmers as well, in which farmers can come and see the site, understand how it works, understand that these systems can be commercially viable, mechanized, etc., and they feel more comfortable adopting them. So there's a dichotomy now between food production and ecological service generation, or environmental protection. And multifunctional woody polycultures could act as a means to break that dichotomy. Within that same particular acre or farm, you have both habitat generation and food production, and not just that, but diverse food production.